Hello everybody, I'm Sneaksy Gamer, and welcome back to Diablo 3 Reaper of Souls, Season 11. Been having a bit of trouble getting it running today. I don't know if their servers are busy, or if it's my computer that's not running good, or what. But something's not running right, so hopefully everything will work okay now that I'm in and playing. This episode, I'm going to be... I changed the difficulty up to Torment 1. Hopefully I don't regret that. And in this episode, I'm going to be going to at least this one, some of these new areas. Change difficulty up to Torment 1 rather than Master because I'm not leveling up enough.
Be gone.
I need to be gaining more experience. Otherwise it will take me way too long to reach level 70. Okay, so that goes into a different area. These places are pretty weird. I haven't done much in them, but the little bit I have done, it's just really weird.
I need a corpse.
Kind of dodge my.
That is not.
I must
possible.
Have a corpse.
My.
Hey, their corpse
I forget
is
what it's
forever.
Called. This one, Army of the Dead, because they went through the wall just as I activated it, and they pretty much just dodged it. Now I don't know which way I'm best to go in this place. I haven't done much in this area. And I mean, the maps are randomized, but I honestly, I don't know. Sometimes you can kind of tell, like, you'll want to go off in this direction because you know that's where the next area is. Like in the steam winds and stuff like that, you can kind of guess you gotta go this way because that's where that place is located, is somewhere off in that direction. But in here, I have no idea where the next place is, if there even is an entrance here to the next one. So that kind of makes it a bit more difficult to figure out where I should head first.
That is not possible. I must have a corpse.
These things suck.
I require a corpse for that.
This place seems pretty cool, but it's pretty weird at the same time because it switches between different places that we've been throughout the game. It's just weird. That was a dead end. I don't know if one of these will lead to another area or not, so I'm not sure which way to go. Like, if I knew for sure this direction would lead me to the next area, I'd go the other way first, so I could just... So I could clear it as best as I can, anyway. But, I don't know. I do like this place, though. It's pretty cool. I'm hopefully gonna level up a bit more in this episode, but...
Do not fear
the corpse.
Nice.
I'm afraid not.
Yeah, this place looks like it's gonna get a bit frustrating.
All must serve the cycle. I'm afraid not.
We've seen the keep depths, we've seen the battlefields of eternity, and we've seen the festering woods so far in this one. What the hell? This is so weird. Places connected by this. It's just, oh, like I've said, it's weird. Doesn't look like these are too big of areas, though. It doesn't seem like they branch off too far, so hopefully that means it won't be too difficult to explore them. I could have just hit this on the way back, because I still have to go that other way, but I didn't want to miss it, just in case there was something in there. Seem pretty linear so far, so that's good. That's good, not too much to go off and explore.
I must have a corpse.
Just as I say that, of course, it turns into a split path. I'm assuming one of them is going to be a dead end, though. I mean, of course one of them will be, but I'm assuming it'll be a dead end pretty quick. Like, it's not gonna go on another run. What is that? This chest.
All must serve the cycle.
Is it kill 100 enemies? Yep. Of course it is.
Not. a corpse for that.
Killed 86, that's not too bad. I think I'm gonna go up this way, because this is probably a dead end. Not far from this. Oh, it is a dead end right there. So I guess it didn't split off, it just looked like it did. Looks like this might be the way I should be going. Is another level connected to this one. Looks like this might be the way to go for it. Worst case scenario, if I get to the end of it, I can just go and use the waypoint to get back. Actually, just open the map and teleport back to the waypoint. I'm quite glad that there's not too much to explore in these things, because I get a bit too distracted when there's a lot to explore, and I get a bit bored sometimes too. Like being in the same place for like an hour is pretty boring. I don't remember seeing those before. Must have those. Can't see them adding a new type of voodoo mask. Back to the Battlefield of Eternity again, huh? This way now.
You will make a fine corp.
I really do like this necromancer. I went back and started to play Diablo 2. And I'm using a necromancer in there right now. And I never really got into it before, but I'm actually liking it quite a bit now. But before, I wasn't as smart about what I did with how I played the game and stuff. I didn't really play to the character's strengths like I do, like I know how to now. I'll just head back to the waypoint and then I'll head off in that other direction. It probably isn't very, very far. I'll head off that way. It's probably a rather abrupt dead end over there, I hope. I mean, I like the experience I get from the places, but I don't like to be in a place for too long. On my own time, it's a bit different, but I tend to want to speed things up a bit when I'm recording. Like, there's a lot of times in on my own time, I wouldn't mind spending an hour in one place. I'd get a little bored, but that's about it. I wouldn't mind it so much. But when I'm recording, I don't want to do that. I want to kind of make it go as quickly as possible. This is going to be another thing like this one. I wonder what places we'll visit here. I'm assuming each of them will bring us to different places. Like that one was the Keep Depths, the Battlefields of Eternity, and the Festering Woods. I'm assuming this is going to be three different places. Or maybe not three, but this one will bring me to different areas that we've been to before. Wolf Gate. That's like at the very start of F5.
I must wait. I require a corpse for that.
That's like outside the city before you go into F5. After you come down that road that leads into F5 and talk to what's his face, Laura, that his name is.
I'm afraid not.
Because then you can't get into the city through the main gates, you have to go around and into the sewers and you run into all the survivors in that one area. It's a place you don't really go to in adventure mode. I don't even know if you can go to it in adventure mode. That is pretty neat the way they did this, though. I don't usually say neat. I don't know why I do it in the videos. Although I don't usually talk to people that much either, so. Maybe that's why. Because I don't normally talk to people, I don't normally say a lot of these things. Okay, so then we go up this way into is this somewhere else or is this it doesn't say anywhere else in the name just yet. There's obviously a divide there. No, this is still the Wolf Gate. Because this is where you go in the story, you go through here, and then right about here where this transition is where you will find the entrance to the place where all the survivors are hiding. Pandemonium Fortress. Of course, taking me to one of the places I would rather not go. Just fine without having to go here.
Yeah. on the mend.
I don't like the Pandemonium Fortress in this game. It's a bit. Can't think of the word right now. It's a bit over the top in this game sometimes. That's not the right term, but something like that. Plus, I ran through this place so many fucking times when I was trying to find the enemies that I ran through this place well over 150 times, maybe even over 200 times when I was looking for the unique enemies before I found the one that I was looking for in here. Or not this place specifically, but in the Pandemonium Fortress. So that could be why I don't like it too, because I've seen it too much. Gets pretty frustrating seeing the same place for just hours and hours and hours on end and not finding what you need to. Eventually I found it, but yeah, that was pretty frustrating. So that's part of why I don't like the Pandemonium Fortress in this one, is because I've spent way too much time in it.
Decay and
the Banish, that's what's it called? That Realm Walker or whatever, that's the portal that opens up after you defeat that thing out in the battlefield. Don't go there too often unless you're out there exploring. At least I don't go there that often. Oh yeah. Don't forget the crystal hives. This is another place I could go without seeing. First set dungeon that I mastered was in this area, and it was took me quite a few tries, so I've seen quite enough of this map as well. Blood Nova. That sounds like it probably hurts. I'm assuming that's one of the skills that uses life as well as essence. Or maybe uses just life, I don't know. Blood Lance. Spend health to launch an additional lance from yourself towards the target. No, thank you. I'd rather not. Spend health to unleash a powerful blood nova that deals damage to all nearby enemies. I'd rather not spend my health to use skills unless they're gonna be very helpful. Unless I can find something that will make those skills a bit more worth it, that will make it a bit more worth spending life, I don't think I'm going to use those things. Unless I find something to do. Like maybe if I find a legendary item that does something different. Champions.
I must wait longer. I must heal. My health is restored.
I don't have enough room for that.
This is well crafted.
Let's head to town. Not leveling up that much in here, actually. I figured going up to Torment 1 would level me up a bit faster, but it doesn't seem to be doing much. I might have to just go public games or get a friend to help me level up or something.
Making sure she isn't up to anything suspicious.
Because at this rate, it's going to take me forever to reach 70. Going one or two levels of video is going to take way too long to reach 70. And it's only going to slow down from here, so... I'm going to have to do something else. Gonna have to do something different here.
No.
Are you kidding me? They were too far away.
I need a corpse.
Wasted that skill because they were too far away for it to target them. Thorn Cemetery. These ones have all been Act 5 places, though. That other one had stuff all over the place. These have all just been Act 5. I'd like to go to a one-handed weapon and, I forget what they're called. The offhand thing for necromancers. But I haven't found any one-handed weapons that'll do me much good. Oh, Oh, Noble's Rest Courtyard. It's not the cemetery. Basically, the cemetery. Oh. Probably gonna be another kill on the dungeons before the timer. Tomahawk. Yep. I'll get the one chest.
Decay and rot. I must wait longer. I must heal. I'm on men. I'm afraid not. That needs to recharge. You will make a fine corpse. Well done.
Level 58. Thought I saw something moving back there. Is it another Leoric's crown, or is this... No, this is the broken crown, I think. Yes, that's a broken crown. Do I want that? I don't want to lose that much recovery. I'm already pretty low on recovery as it is. Okay. Well, I can't imagine this being too much fun of an area.
The night embraces you.
Either way, when I get to the end of this one, I'm gonna end the episode. Okay. I guess that's the end of it then. There weren't any other paths. Nope.
I am returning.
Okay, I guess
town.
I'm heading to town and I'll end this one here then. I will explore, I believe there's two more or three more areas. I'll check the map real quick. There's either two or three of them left, and I'll explore those in the next episode. Ah, there's four of them left, so it might be another two episodes, depending on how big they are. Destroying legendaries. I need to extract powers from them in this season for part of the journey, I think. Well, anyway, that's it for this episode. Thank you, everybody, for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And as always, I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.